Welcome back, everybody. Gooey here with a new, brand new series, brand new Minecraft series. And welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm glad to say hi to you all. If you guys are here, thank you guys for tuning in to see the episode. But now, let me explain this, alright? So, today we're playing Archaica, The Secrets of Silas, Morrow. And so I've already played this a little bit, and I've got the gist of it. So there's certain things that we need to do. Currently, we're right here. My game mode's been updated. So currently, we're right here, right? And we just got to explore all of these little areas. I don't know. There's an arrow there, so there's probably something right there. But as you can see, there's a big area for us to explore. So this is going to be pretty fun. Now, there is stuff right here. The starting items you may have are in this chest. Take what you would like. You may never know what you need. So basically, we're going to take all this. Everything. Oh, I was trying to space click. All right, let's get all this stuff and put it in our inventory. Okay, so these are already certain maps. So, like I said, I have been doing this a little bit. I have used this stuff a little bit. I don't know everything about this. But let's drop some stuff off in our ender chest. I don't really know what we're going to do first. But let's drop this off. We'll take our regen potion. We need this. But first, let's look at this. So, I don't know how to say that. So, Archaica intro. You are in the distant world of Archaica. The area you are in of this distant world is called the Land of the Unwanted. Many people come here because they feel lonely, helpless, and or forgotten. No matter what situation anyone is in, there has been one person constantly tormenting the minds of those who came here. Silas Morrow. Supposedly, he knows things that could help or destroy the world. Figure out what exactly happened to Silas. He is the key to figure out the ultimate secret of this land. So, by that little intro that you guys saw there, this is actually an adventure map, and this is the area we gotta search, and it's over there. Obviously, it's over there. There is this thing, the border that we have to stay in, so yeah. Alright, Archaica presets. And these are just kind of rules. Normal, don't break blocks, play in survival mode, use any resource pack, and objectives, gold and silver objectives. And as you can see on the side, those are the objectives that we have to complete all of them. Well, we don't have to, but for a good full series, we have to complete all of them. Alright, so clue one. We've already stepped on this, so our game mode is updated and ready to go. And, alright, clue. Calum is the weakest of the gods. She cannot complete her task. She has enlisted his help, and even he has failed. So there's clue number one. Let's keep that in our inventory. I don't know if we're supposed to have inventory mode on, or keep inventory mode on. So we're going to kind of leave our outpost. And I did play this for a few minutes. So I know the gist of everything. It looks like there's something over here in this little bay area. So let's actually go look at this. It looks like there's something up there. In there, and there's a few furnaces. So it said don't break any blocks, but you can place them. So I'm thinking we could kill cows maybe, and I didn't mean to break that boat, but whatever. Hopefully we get more wood. Hopefully we don't need this boat. Let's get up here. Yeah, it does look like there is some stuff in here. So, hidden chest, haggis brother. Alright, there's a crafting table. We don't really need anything. Let's check this chest. And there's a whole bunch of steak. And a whole bunch of raw beef. Haggis brother and clue. And gifted fishing rod. So we could go fishing for a little while. And we got another raft. Let's see if there's any coal in here. There doesn't seem to be. Alright, let's take a quick sleep. Peppered steak. Alright, so let's eat some peppered steak after this. And let's read this clue. Or let's read Haggis' brother first. I am Haggis' brother. I am on this land because I must know its secrets. The only one I know of the treasure behind the waterfall. The only one I know of is... Oh, okay. The only one I know of is the treasure behind the waterfall. I don't need it. Someone else should take it. Lyro, the god of the earth, seems to be only god who pays any attention to me. Maybe it's because I am after the secrets. Is Lyro behind all of them? He has gifted me with items, but I think it is all to distract me from my one single task, to know the ultimate secret of this land. My time is running out here in the overworld. I need to work fast, unless the gods stop me. Alright, now let's read. I don't think we need that. We can drop our books off here. Let's drop this wood off. Or we'll take the raft with us. Now let's read the clue, number 2. Lyro is just being a pain at times. He seems to be focused on something, keeping something a secret. Does he think that I am a threat? Is Lyro behind the island's secrets? So there's clue number 2. Now, we should go look for some other clues. Oh, there's a structure over there. I didn't see that. Let's go towards that, actually. Hopefully, we don't break our boat. We probably will. Hopefully not, though. We can't break any blocks. I saw coal over there. Let's stop before... Alright. Let's get out of here and take our raft back. And let's go explore these ruins. Let's see if there's any secret things. There's a chest here. So let's open it and see what we got. We got a clock, an arcane clock, the timekeeper, and some cooked chicken, and the timekeeper's key. So let's check up here first before anything. Ugh, that's a difficult jump. Let's check up here before we do anything. Just to make sure that there's nothing else up here. And it doesn't look like there's a gold plate. We do need to step on these gold plates. So let's step on this one. This area used to be the location of a clock tower. This area was where lots of new lost arcane knowledge was used. This area shows proof of this land having been a lot nicer of a place in the past. Alright, so we still have to find a hidden chest, I think. I don't know. Let's go step on this golden pressure plate. Alright, sorry guys for that little interruption. I actually just got a phone call. But yes, let's go step on this gold plate, and then we will read these two. You will not want to be caught in or around this bay in a storm. The wind and rain pelts with such force that you cannot stay here. If anyone lives here, they must be driven by some want or need. And I also forgot to mention that this map is... get up here. This map is, in fact, created by Josh_98765. I will leave a link to the map download in the description if you guys want to. And also give Matt a shout-out. There's a plate down there we need to go check. I'll give Josh a shout-out. And, yeah, so if all the details will be in the description. So now let's read. Let's put that away. Let's read the timekeeper and the clue. Let's read the timekeeper first. Arcane magic used to reside here. I would put together amazing things for the people of Archaica. Things changed. There was a period of despair for the people of this world. That was when people started coming to this land. I have and will reside here at this clock tower until its last toll sounds. Now this world is different. The periods of despair definitely took a toll. The gods definitely realized they needed to help their people more, especially those that feel lost and hopeless. Now let's read the clue. Lyro is just being a pain at times. He seems to be focused on something, keeping something a secret. Does he think that I am a threat? Is Lyro behind the island's secrets? I think we actually already read that. So I guess we can keep that. Now let's go down there. Ooh, there's a gold plate right here. So, the bay is near a very sketchy swamp, so it is named Danger Bay. Clue. Why does Caleb not want to go into the swamp? She's saying she senses death. Well, let's go on in. Alright, make sure there's nothing over here that we can see. Doesn't look like it. Let's take a quick dip. Sorry guys for that quick interruption. I just got another phone call. But we may resume. Alright, let's step on this. This area is riddled with skeletons. Take extreme caution. Not many venture here, and those who do don't usually return. So let's keep going. Actually, let's climb up on the trees. And she said there's something in the swamp, so... I mean, I'm guessing either it's that plate or it's something else. So, let's just keep... It's a small swamp, so we can keep searching for it. And there's another plate here, and there's a whole bunch of stuff. All right. Here lies Martha Everwood, the tear giver. Who's Martha Everwood? So we have the dead man's axe, only held by those who have perished. What? So, 5, 6. All right, our sword's better. Let's take these bones, because you never know when they'll be useful. The block of redstone and clue. Let's drop some stuff off. And let's put all of our clues right here. Let's organize this a bit. That's a clue. And let's read this one. First, let's step on this. It seems as if her grave was dug up at some point in time. It seems pretty spooky. Alright, clue number one. Why was this grave dug up? What would someone need from this grave? Why was she buried here? A block of redstone. So let's drop that in there, and a block of redstone. I'm not too sure. Let's just put all this stuff together. Arcane clock, we'll take our boat, dead man's axe, gifted fishing rod, and Robbie. So our inner chest is filling up quite a bit. That's not too good. We'll have to start using stuff. But let's continue checking the swamp out. Let's see if there's anything on these trees. Now, we can't break blocks. I would assume the leaves are blocks that we can't break. But it looks like there's something up there. So, we're going to go look up there. And swamp visitors. So, we have to do all of these things on this map to accomplish all the goals. I don't know where all the hidden chests are. I'm actually not too sure. But let's get in here and explore this area, and then I think I'll end the episode off there. We can't go down there. There is a chest. Can we get back up if we drop down there? What does that do? Engine's ready. Alright, let's check this chest. We got Pilot Silas and Rotten Potato. Prepare airship launch. Whoa. Not too sure what that's doing, but let's read this. I am glad that Caleb told me about the location of this airship. The ship was hidden here long ago, and I brought it back to the skies. I rode it to my homeland because I was told there was destruction. Yes, people had died. There was a plague, but life seemed to be going on normally for the most part. I was sent to retrieve a redstone block. Apparently, 5 redstone blocks have been cast under spells to keep Ignis, the goddess of fire, from escaping her cell. Oh. Underground. Her cell is located underneath the land of the unwanted. I got the redstone block, but there were 4 more. All were apparently hidden on the land so that I was living. On the land that I was living. So, I set off to find them, eliminating people who may have been threats. I found 1 more block. 3 remain. My death is going to come before I find the rest. Ignis needs to be free. Lyro trapped her there because she threatened to set his earth alight during an argument. Caleb has been trying to find the blocks, but can't, and found me thinking I would be noble enough to find the rest of the blocks. Someone needs to find them. Lyro must be punished, and Caleb needs to be worshipped forever. because of her good deeds, Aquam, the god of water, has stayed out of the drama. Maybe Lyro has killed him. I will never know. The blocks must be found, and soon. Ignis will want her revenge. Alright, so we got a little bit left to check out. Let's put this in our ender chest. We don't need blocks. Where did I get blocks from? I think I broke blocks, actually. So, I didn't do it. This is an airship hangar that hasn't been used in a while. It has been hidden from view and nobody has found it until you've stumbled upon it. What secrets does it hold? Let's actually hang out down here. It looks like there's something over there. Maybe a redstone torch. Broken wooden sword, and so this wasn't very good. So we don't need the wooden sword. Let's leave that, but let's take everything else and get out of here. And actually, what's over here? I'm not too sure what's in there, but that's going to be the end of this episode. If you guys are super excited for this series like I am, this is a fun series so far, make sure to smash up that like button. And also, if you guys want to stick around for episode number 2, then make sure to hit that subscribe button, stick around for more, and make sure to tune in for the next episode of Archaica Island Adventure. I'll see you guys next time. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, like I said, stick around for more, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out.